I'm Deborah Borchardt, and this is your Marijuana Money Minute. It was a big week in Washington for the industry, and I don't mean the impeachment hearings. The House Judiciary Committee passed the MORE Act, which is legislation to remove cannabis from the Controlled Substances Act, and it will decriminalize it. They also put in language to remove prior and pending marijuana convictions. The next step is for this legislation to go to a full House vote, and then on to the Senate. After that, it would still need to be signed by the president. It still is the most comprehensive cannabis legislation introduced in Congress. Well, we started the week absorbing news that was released after the market closed on Friday last week, and that was that MedMen was slashing its ranks and scaling back on its expansion plans. 190 employees got pink slips, and the company said it was selling off some of its assets. It was another big week for earnings. We're just going to hit the high notes here. Trulieve announced Q3 revenue of $70 million. That beat estimates. And they reported a nice net income of $57 million. Green Thumb Industries reported third quarter revenue of $68 million, and they trimmed their net loss down to $17 million. Harvest Health delivered revenue of $33 million for the third quarter, but their net loss came in higher at $39 million. Beleaguered Tilt Holdings turned a corner and delivered net income for the quarter of $26 million on revenue of $46 million. Ianthus reported $22 million in revenue, but they also had a net loss of $15 million. Not a good week for Aurora Cannabis. They reported a drop in revenue and said that they suspended construction on two of their largest greenhouses. In other news, HEXO reported that it was growing plants in unlicensed rooms. But unlike CanTrust, Health Canada said they were okay with the actions that the company was taking. And then finally, Seneva took a big hit as the company's president resigned, and it was just 1 week after the CFO quit. And that's it for this week. I'm Deborah Borchardt reporting for the Green Market Report from Times Square.